USB cables. Who needs this junk? Oh, and why use it for audio? Today, we're going to talk about something you already know about, or do you? USB cables. You probably have at least 1,482,647 lying around your house somewhere, or rather everywhere. They come with literally every electronic device on the planet nowadays. It's annoying, it's wasteful, and quite frankly, they're all just not gonna cut it when it comes to your high resolution audio. I mean, that's why you're here, right? You're an audiophile or a music lover, and you wanna know why Moon Audio is spending an entire video talking about USB cables. In this business, cables are the connection between you and your music. And if your audio data isn't getting from point A to point B the way it's supposed to, that doesn't mean good things for audio quality. We'll get to more on that in a bit, but let's just start going over some of the basics of USB and why it's so common. USB stands for Universal Serial Bus, and it's the most common connection protocol for electronic devices today. It's able to fulfill a number of different tasks, such as transmitting data and charging. The USB protocol has been updated over time since its creation, resulting in faster data transfer and charging speeds. Even though two cables might be USB cables, they can look completely different and also have varying performance, as well as, in the case of USB audio cables, not be as universal as the name suggests, right? There are a variety of USB connector types, and they can sometimes be indicators of what generation device they go with, depending on the design, color, and connector type. It's not always so cut and dry, however. USB Type A. In the early days of USB, the most common connector was a USB Type A. And still is the most common type today. This is the rectangular shaped connector that fits into most portable wall chargers, computer ports for peripherals and devices, and more. Type B connectors are larger connectors, nearly square shaped, and were common with older peripherals like printers and such. The latest standard for USB connection is the Type-C connector. There are a lot of great things about the newer connector, from the fact that it's smaller than previous USB type connectors, and it's also double-sided, meaning that you can connect it properly from either side. While USB-C is pretty well accepted in the portable audio product world, it has not made great strides in the home audio landscape. For one thing, it's small and it's not as stout. Thus, in a home audio environment with larger cables, it's more prone to being damaged. We feel that USB-B in either 2.0 or 3.0 format is the way to go with home audio. So what's the deal with USB audio? There's an important distinction to make when it comes to audio-specified USB cables. Audio USB cables like Moon Audio's Silver and Black Dragon USB cables are not meant for usual data transmission in the way that you would connect a hard drive to your computer. Audio cables do not need all the pins for data that some USB cables utilize. Because here's the big takeaway. USB audio and USB audio devices don't need the bandwidth of USB 3.0 and up. USB 2.0 can handle up to 480 megabytes per second. And as a reference, a 24-bit 192 kilohertz audio file only uses about 10 megabytes per second for each audio track, meaning that a stereo track only uses 20 megabytes per second, or just 5% of the total possible USB 2.0 bandwidth and transfer speeds. Anything more is just completely unnecessary. When we say that a USB cable is meant for audio transmission only, this means that the cable should only be used for connecting your source to a DAC or music streamer, just as an example. The only thing that should be transmitted through the cable then is your audio data. You might ask, why would I get a cable that only does audio when I can get a stock USB cable that does everything? Answer? The same reason why audiophiles and music lovers buy a standalone DAC or a high-end preamplifier or music streamer. The fact is that a standalone device or devices meant to do one thing perform better than do-it-all devices. Better materials, better quality construction, and the fact that something was designed specifically for one purpose means the same thing for cables. In this case, creating and configuring a cable for specific USB audio needs means that it will do that job much better than a standard mass-produced cable made with subpar materials. Materials matter. And that's an important part of the equation for audio. Dragon USB audio cables are not designed to be used as hard drive cables because the transfer speeds are not meant for high capacity data transfer. High transfer data speeds use more pins and conductors in a cable to be able to more efficiently move lots of data from point A to point B. Dragon USB audio cables are designed with only the conductors and pins necessary to transmit audio data only. If a typical USB 3.0 cable connector has 24 pins, that means we'd have to have 24 conductors of UPOCC silver and copper, and that adds up, resulting in really expensive cables. We typically use 4 to 5 pins for audio transfer, which is all you need. Your gear is only as good as its weakest link, and in most cases, it's the stock cables. Companies just don't put the R&D into their cables like they do for the device. That being said, the Silver Dragon USB cable is a higher quality cable than your OEM option and is built to spec with premium materials and components. Year after year, this is one of our top selling Dragon cables. We have all the connectors mentioned previously, and we can build just about any type of USB cable imaginable. Why is a quality USB cable important for your DAP, DAC, or other audio gear? Well, because they can be used as a high quality source for your DAC in your home system. It can take the place of a computer, or be used as your server and streamer. Some DAPs are even Rune endpoints and vice versa. These can also be used as headphone amps and DACs for your laptop when you are working remotely. There are a lot of reasons why you need to make sure that your USB cables are not afterthoughts, no matter what source device you are plugging them into. Hopefully this guide has helped you figure out how to sort that box or drawer full of unused or old cables and what they connect to. For high resolution audio purposes, USB cables need to be made with high quality materials in order to minimize performance issues and data packet loss. As an in-house high quality cable manufacturer, feel free to contact us with any questions that you might have. If you need a custom cable solution, we have one of the largest collections of cable connectors around and we'll be more than happy to assist you however we can. Your music deserves better than a stock cable, so it's time to unleash the true potential of your audio. Be sure to check out our guide, link in the description below, for lots more info on USB cables and why they matter. If you like this video, be sure to hit that thumbs up and remember to subscribe for more content just like this. If you have any questions, drop a comment. And as always, thanks for watching.